one in a million years. This is for all the girls, boys all over the world. Whatever you've been told, you're worth more than gold. So hold your head up high, if your time shines. From the inside out it shows, you're worth more than gold. You're worth more than gold. Okay, Katie, what is today?
Snow day.
And Beck cooked us breakfast. Yum. Mom, say hey. You're not in the video, but...
Good morning, everybody.
And we'll get outside shots later, but look.
Yay.
Okay, y'all. It's January 3rd, 2018.
Hey.
In Eastern North Carolina, and it never snows, and it's a snow day.
We're so excited.
Yeah.
I got off work.
Well, but I'm still cold. On Christmas
it's
break,
cold.
So.
It's cold.
So, like we said earlier, it's a snow day. We didn't vlog that much outside because we were scared I was going to drop my camera in the snow.
It's cold.
Yeah, but... I'm about to get Katie to tell you a funny story of our mom trying to take pics of us.
So we're... You wanna Yeah. So in our backyard, Mom tasked Anna and I with getting some like fresh snow for snow cream.
Because we were dumb and didn't leave out a bucket.
Well, yeah. And like down south, snow cream is snow, obviously, vanilla extract. And you can use like sweetened condensed milk or just like milk, I think. So Mom was like, go get some fresh snow, obviously, like not with grass and stuff. So she gives a bowl and a ladle and we're scooping. And then I see our blinds crack open and she is trying to take photos of us on her camera, her phone, whatever. And between the glass is like a screen, and so the picture, hold on, I'm gonna see if you can, I can pull it up on here and you can see.
So the picture has like grids all over it, and she sends it to us, and she's like, prison snow kids.
I don't know if y'all can see it, it's like snow prison.
Like, really?
The life of Becky Strickland.
Then we told her to take pics of us. She takes like 20 and I'm like, okay, that's enough. I walk to it and she takes one of me like this.
I didn't know this was roast your mom.
That's Mom in the background. Say hey, Beck.
Hey.
She pissed.
She's awesome.
She did cook us breakfast though.
And that was good.
We're thankful. Good, cute mom. So since I didn't vlog much outside, I'll post pictures of the snow. And yes, we're cheesy and wearing matching headbands because that's what we do.
Because why not?
See y'all later.
Bye.
Hey, Beck.
Hey.
How do you feel about snow day?
Oh, I love it. I'm so thankful to have an extra day home with my girls, and I love the snow. It's a gift from God, for sure.
Your makeup looks pretty.
Oh, thank you.
Here, take your glasses off. It's got a glare. Are you wearing that Tartlet In Bloom palette I bought you?
Yes, I am.
And that Lorac lipstick?
Yes.
And y'all, I'm not kidding, my mom uses Shape Tape. Look.
Look, uses what?
Tarte Shape Tape. Close your eyes. Look how good her skin looks. Guess how old she is in the comments.
I'm just kidding. Don't.
Be kind, please.
Love you, Mom. And she cooked us breakfast this morning. It was good.
It's been a good day so far. Mm-hmm. Thank you, Lord.
Are we going to have a snowball fight?
That's yet to be determined.
Or are you just going to hit me in the face with snow?
I may. You never know.
Are you going to make snow cream?
Yes, definitely. Love ya.
Love you too.
Bye. Hey y'all, so it's been a few hours now since the last clip you saw of me and my mom, and we've all just been kind of hanging out. It's super cold, so we're just kind of all like chilling in our rooms and stuff. And so I decided to finish up this vlog by showing y'all an updated eyeshadow palette collection, because I think I posted my full eyeshadow palette collection in February. It may have been later than that or earlier than that. I'm not quite sure when it was, but I've gotten a lot of palettes since then, and this is in no way like bragging or anything. Eyeshadow palettes are just like my obsession, my favorite makeup product to buy. Like almost every time I get paid from work or holiday or anything, like I save up money to buy new eyeshadow palettes, because that's what I really, really love. Like if that was the only makeup product I could buy for the rest of my life, then I would probably pick eyeshadow palettes and be fine with it. So for this collection or whatever, I'm not going to show you every single eyeshadow palette I have. I'm just going to show you the new ones that I got since that last video to kind of update you what I've added to my collection. And I just have a pile right beside me, and they're in no particular order. I haven't even sorted them by brand or anything. It's just a pile. So let's jump right into it. The first one, I got this, I want to say early or mid-November. This is the Anastasia Beverly Hills Prism Palette, and this is her holiday palette. It is beautiful, and what I'll say is, it's a very good companion to the Subculture palette, which is also in this. I got this over the summer. So, Prism Subculture. The Subculture has mostly mattes. This has more shimmers, so they work well together. But what I will say is that a lot of people were scared to buy the Prism palette because, I don't know if you know this, if you've been in the beauty community at all or watching YouTube videos, there was so much drama around the Subculture palette. Like a lot of people just hated it. The eyeshadows didn't work well for them. They just did not like them. Personally, I guess I got, oh, I just threw the brush out. I got one of the Good Batch palettes because I really like this palette. The shadows are like other Anastasia palettes. They're very pigmented and buttery, but they do kick up a lot of powder, but they blended really well on my eyes and I really enjoyed it. But what I will say is the Prism palette is a little bit different. It does feel like a little bit of a different formula from Subculture, because I will say Subculture is different than Modern Renaissance. Like it's, they are more powdery and you have to be extra careful with these. And the Prism one, I would compare more to the Modern Renaissance. So if you didn't like the Subculture and you can still get this, if you like the colors, I would recommend it. And I'll swatch these two shades. This is Pyramid and Throne. They are gorgeous. And I'm not going to swatch Subculture just because there's so many videos about this. You can look it up. But overall, I would recommend both of these. Okay, the next palette is the Zulu palette by Juvia's Place. And if you see this and look at my eyes, like I mostly wear neutral eye looks. Like, yeah, I'm dramatic with my makeup, but I don't incorporate a lot of color. So I haven't used this one that much, but I will say
The pigment is there. They do blend well. Like, Juvia's Place does not disappoint. And if you've never tried it, you really should. But that's one of my things for 2018, is that I want to incorporate more color into my makeup looks. Look at that pigment. It's gorgeous. And I just swatched two shimmers, but the matte colorful shades are just as pretty. So if you're into color or want to get more into color, I highly recommend Juvia's Place. Okay, the next palette, everyone on YouTube has talked about. It's been in almost everyone's favorites. Honestly, I should have put it in my 2017 makeup favorites. It's the Jaclyn Hill Morphe palette. And I have the old packaging that isn't shiny, so it does kind of get dirty. But this just has everything you need. Mattes, shimmers. If you like warm tones, it has all of those. But it also has color, if you like that. And I just feel like this palette is a great one because you pull it out. You don't need other shades. You don't need any other palettes. Like, you have a highlight. Many choices of lid shades. So many shades that could be transition shades, no matter what your skin tone. Plus, deeper shades to, like, darken out the outer corner. This is a beautiful palette. It's stunning. I know Jaclyn and Morphe worked really hard on it, and it's $38, which is a little bit more than normal Morphe pricing, but it is totally worth it. I highly recommend. Okay, while we're on the Morphe train, I got the Morphe 3502. I love this, but I will say I love warm tones. I know a lot of people are sick of all these companies coming out with warm tone palettes, but I really like them. I think they look good with my brown eyes. And this formula is just like the Jaclyn Hill Morphe palette formula. It's just creamy, blendable. The shimmers are great. The mattes are great. And every time I use this, I feel like my eyeshadow looks good. So I definitely recommend this. But if you don't like warm tones, then obviously skip out on it because it's just not going to be for you. Okay, I guess we'll stick with warm tones. The next is the Urban Decay Naked Heat. And again, it's warm tone. And I've honestly, a lot of videos I've seen, a lot of hate on this because, like, to me personally, like, in the beauty world, everyone knows about the Naked palettes. I feel like anyone who, like, just gets into makeup, like, one of the Naked palettes is, like, your first high-end palette. I know when I was a freshman in college is when I first got a high-end palette. And I had watched so many videos about, at that time, there were three Naked palettes out. The Naked 1, the Naked 2, and the 3 had just come out. And I saved up money and spent like over $150 to get all three at once. And I was so excited. A lot of people have just hated on this palette. They're like, I'm over the Naked palettes, whatever. But honestly, I think they're really good. And I mean, now there are palettes that I'm like, oh, they're a creamier, better formula. But I feel like the Naked palettes just have like sentimental value to me because they're like my first eyeshadow, high-end eyeshadow palettes that I got. And I really love this. And I do think it's good quality. And I think Urban Decay is stepping up their eyeshadow game. So I highly recommend this. And speaking of the Naked palettes, I had an idea to start a series on my channel. Because I know a lot of people like can't go out and keep buying high-end eyeshadows over and over again. Like, because it's a lot of money to look in my collection and have like older palettes that used to be really popular or something like that, like do makeup looks with those and like, or a video about like how to get the good trendy eyeshadow look with old eyeshadow palettes so you don't have to buy like every new palette that comes out, if that makes sense. Let me know if that's something y'all would want to see or not, because that's just kind of what I've been brainstorming lately. But let's move on. So the next palette is actually in my 2017 makeup favorites. It's also warm tone. It is the Tarte Lip Toasted. I love this palette. I just love like the gold shades, the warm shades. It's really good. Like I'm really into the Tarte Lip palettes. Just the pigmentation, the blendability is there, and I feel like they're warm tones, but this isn't as scary of a palette as like the Morphe 3502 that just like looks like a bunch of reds and it would look like the same color. Like I feel like you could go super natural with this, like, or bolder. It could be a day or night look, and I feel like this could easily become someone's everyday palette. Okay, next, let's see. Oh, I have another Juvia's Place palette. Two, actually. So this one is the Saharan palette. And this has a good mix of like shimmers and neutral colors. And honestly, when I look at this, like at first I'm like, how do they put these colors together? But I feel like every time I pull this out, like I come up with a creative, sort of out of the box, but wearable eyeshadow look. And the formula is awesome. There's shimmers and mattes. I didn't swatch the black very well, but this is a great palette and I really, really like it. So definitely check that out. And the other Juvia's Place palette is called the Magic, and it's a bigger one. And it has some neutrals, but it also has colors. And this is more, I would say, more of a cool tone palette. And more, like it has color in it, but they're more muted. So this might be, I really think this would be good for someone who's kind of like me, who wants to start incorporating color into their looks more often, but doesn't want to jump in right away with like a bright pink or something like that. This could be really good for you. And I think it's a good mix of like cool and warm tones, shimmers and mattes, and I just think it's really pretty. And I've used it 5 or 6 times and I really like it. Okay, next is the Laura Lee Los Angeles palette. Now, before I even get into the product, I just have to give it to her on this outer packaging. That glitter is everything. Like, every time I look at this palette, I smile. And honestly, I got this palette because I wasn't really gonna get it because I'm subscribed to Laura Lee. I do really like her, but I don't watch her videos like religiously. Like there's some YouTubers who, as soon as they post, I watch their videos. She's not really one of them. I've been watching her more lately, but my friend Madison, who also has a YouTube channel, she loves Laura Lee. And she was talking about that she was gonna order this palette. And then I saw it and the colors just like screamed out to me because it's super neutral. Like there's mauvey tones, warm tones. Just, this is like a great everyday palette, but you could also go really smoky with it, and I really like it. And I think it's awesome that Laura Lee, like I watched one of her videos the other day. I think it was a Q&A, and she talked about like coming from nothing, like having no money hardly in Alabama, and now like she has a few million subscribers on YouTube, lives in LA, sorry my voice is cracking, and has started her own makeup company. Like That's awesome. And I give her props for this. So if she comes out with other stuff, I definitely will buy it. The next product was super hyped, and I think it's worth all the hype. It's the Huda Beauty Desert Dusk Palette. It's very purpley warm. When I look at this, I think of like sunset makeup, like purple, reddish oranges, and then there's a glitter, sparkly shades, shimmery shades, and these are just gorgeous. There's some swatches if you can see. I've been using this palette, like, out of all the ones I'm going to talk about, this is probably one of my most used palettes. I don't know what it is, but I reach for this all the time because I love the purpley warm looks that I can come up with it. I adore this palette, and I highly, highly recommend it. Okay, the next palettes, if you've watched any of my videos or talked to me in person, probably won't surprise you at all. So my favorite eyeshadow formula for the past like 3 years has been Lorac, and it still is. Well, I don't know if I told this story, but a few years ago, they came out with a holiday palette. It was their first one, the Lorac Mega Pro palette. Well, it sold out within a few days before I could get it. Like, I was going to ask for it for Christmas. Well, this year, because people requested it so much, they re-released it on their website. And you know, I picked it up. I love this. Now, what I'll say about Lorac is that their eyeshadows are super pigmented. Like, you need the littlest amount. If you dip your brush too heavy into it, like especially a dark color, you better tap off that brush or you will get it all over your eye. And not in a good way. But they blend like a dream. They are the best blending eyeshadows that I've ever used. The mattes and the shimmers. And I just love the formula. But I think you have to love Lorac shadows, I think you have to really be willing to work with eyeshadows. Like, if you're a beginner, I wouldn't recommend this because you really have to blend and like make it work. I don't really know if I'm describing that really well, but if you like the colors, I said it's not that great for beginners, but I do highly recommend it. Lorac is my favorite. I'm not really describing it well, but I love this palette. So then the next year, I got the Lorac Mega Pro 2. That was a holiday palette. I showed y'all that in my last eyeshadow palette collection video. Well then, last year, Christmas of 2016, the Lorac Mega Pro 3 came out. Well, I asked for it for Christmas, but when my mom went to buy it, it was sold out. But they re-released it this year also, so I got it. It's very warm toned. Well, I wouldn't even say warm toned. This is a super neutral palette. You can see I've used it a lot. And I already talked about the formula. It's wonderful, amazing, blendable, super, super, super pigmented. And that's what I was saying earlier. That's what I meant. It's so pigmented that you have to be willing to blend it out. Because I know many times, like if I haven't used it in a while, I'll like tap my brush in and get too much. And then have to blend so much on my eye because I put way too much, more than I need. So just know when you're using these, a little goes a long way. Love this. And then this year, their Mega Pro 4 is very cool toned. And at first I saw this and I didn't think I would like it, but I really love it because I'm trying to get into more colors this year, but also like more cool tone looks because I've just been overboard with warm tones this year. So I'm hoping to get more use out of this. And I think recently I saw on the Ulta website that this was on sale. So if it is on sale, it was like half price. You should definitely pick it up. Okay. And then this year was the year of me trying out the Ciate London brand eyeshadows. And they are the collaboration with Chloe Morello, who is a YouTuber. The Pretty Fun and Fearless palette, and then the Pretty Fun and Fearless Volume 2. And of course, I want to support YouTubers. I love her. Her accent is amazing. She has beautiful makeup. I'm just obsessed with her. And this is super neutral, just a great everyday palette. And the pigment really is there. I've been pleasantly surprised. What I will say in this is that normally I've heard that it's harder to do mattes than it is shimmers, but the mattes in these palettes are so much better than the shimmers. Like that pink shade right here is the shimmer, and it didn't swatch half as well as these matte shades. So I will say that, but it's very blendable and easy to work with. And then the Volume 2 palette has some brighter shades. It's just like a vamped up version of the first one. The hot pinks, the kind of muted purples. I really want to do a look with the greens right here. But yeah, I really like it. Okay. Next, I'm not going to talk about this one too much because I talked about it in my favorites, but this is the Just Peachy Mattes palette by Too Faced. And I feel like this palette is a perfect addition to any eye look you want to do. And what I mean by that is that it's full of mattes, so any look that you need a transition shade for, you can use these. A matte highlight shade, or that you want to deepen up, like add browns or deeper colors, or this like berry pinkish color, you could use all of these. So I feel like this, whatever eye look you're doing, this could just enhance the look. So if I'm using this palette, this could just make the eye look even better. So I feel like this is just a staple to have in your collection for those days when you just need a little something extra to your eye look and you don't know what. This could really help. Okay, what else? Oh, so I really got into ColourPop palettes this year too. I have three. So I have the Cute AF palette. And if you didn't know, ColourPop is now sold at Sephora, but they're a pretty affordable brand. This is a super warm palette. It's gorgeous. Golden tones, warm tones. I love it. I think I got this for $15. And y'all, the pigmentation is like high end. Like, I'm blown away every time I use this. Now this is more of the mauve-y pink tones, and again, the pigmentation is there. I love it. Do I think you need all of these palettes? No, but I'm showing all of them to you so you can see, hey, I really like these shades, and check it out. Now my favorite of the ColourPop palettes I have is the I Think I Love You palette, and it's just very neutral. You could do a perfect smoky eye with this, a lighter look. I really love this palette. And I love the shiny packaging. Clearly, I'm easily amused. Okay, four more palettes left. I just got the Tarte Clay Play Volume 2 palette. It's gorgeous. This is the ultimate everyday palette. You've got bronzer, blush, highlight, shimmery eyeshadows, matte eyeshadows. It's very neutral, perfect for travel because then You have your eye look and most of your face products in here. So I highly, highly recommend. Tarte shadows have been one of my favorites this year, or this past year in 2017. And I definitely recommend checking this out. Okay, next. I've also showed this in another video, so I won't spend too much time on it, but this is the Kat Von D Slant and Center palette. Again, this does not disappoint. Kat Von D's shadows are super blendable. I love her mattes, but the shimmers are also great, and this is a great combination of shimmers and mattes and cool and warm tones, plus like a little bit of neutral and colors. And at first, I didn't want to buy this, but when I went to Sephora and swatched it, I was like, I need it. And I feel like this palette pushes me out of the box and like to be more creative with my makeup. So I love this. Okay, the last two are Violet Voss palettes, which is now sold at Sephora, but I think it's only online. So I have the Holy Grail palette, which is again another like warm neutral palette. Again, this is a good everyday palette. These shadows, this formula, like I love my Lorac shadows, but I think this is a close second because they like are so buttery and creamy to the touch, easy to blend, and the pigmentation is there, the mattes and the shimmers, and I love it. And that was the Holy Grail palette. And then the next one is the Taupe Notch palette. And this is like super, like it says, taupey, neutral, basic, everyday eyeshadow palette. And I find myself reaching for this a lot when I don't know what to do with my makeup and just want something that's easy and quick on the eyes. This is great for that, for every day. But I will say, if you aren't used to like using taupe colors or blending stuff out, all blending eyeshadows out a lot and like mixing shades, this can, if you don't know how to put a look together, look like you're putting the same shade everywhere because it's like different shades of taupe. So you do have to be careful with it. But I love this, and I love using it in combination with my other palettes. So that's gonna do it for my eyeshadow palette collection and for this vlog. Thank you so much for watching. I love you guys so much. Please like this video and subscribe to my channel, and let me know your ideas for videos in the comments below. What you think of this eyeshadow palette collection, or what your favorite palettes are. If there's any that I haven't mentioned that you think I should try, let me know. And I'll see you in my next one. Bye!